So Kittl just released an eraser tool. It's something we've been wanting to have for a long, long time. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use it, a couple of tips and tricks, shortcuts that you can use, and why you might be wanting to use this. I'll show you a different way that you may not have thought of to use the eraser tool. So let's go into Kittl right now, and I'll show you exactly where it is, how to use it, and all the special things. All right, so here we are on Kittl, K-I-T-T.com right there, Kittl.com. If you have never been to here, it's an amazing site to create graphics. You can see you can create t-shirts, logos, all kinds of stuff, and it's all online on your desktop. Just going to here, Kittl.com. Now you can use it for free to practice and learn stuff, but if you're gonna use it for print on demand, I would subscribe to it so that you can save it as a bigger size. But let me show you the eraser tool that we've been wanting for a long, long time. I'm gonna hit new project right here, and I'm just going to pick a pod preset. So let's say I'm doing a t-shirt. This is merch by Amazon. They already have it all preset up, which is really cool. I'm gonna hit that and create. Now we're gonna have to zoom out. I'm holding down option and using my scroll wheel on my mouse, which is really cool. And I can just move this here. So option, in and out, really cool. Shortcuts are really nice. So the eraser tool is great for images, not vectors. So I'll show you the difference. So how you can know the difference. If we go to elements here first, let's go on here. Now this, you can tell with the illustration colors, is a vector. This is not gonna be able to use the erase tool. You'll notice it's not even asking me for it. But if we go to, let's say something more complex usually, let's go to illustrations. In fact, I bet a bunch of these are all vectors. Yeah, so even this one like this, oh no. So this one like this is not a vector. So you can see it says image vectorizer. Once it's a raster or a photo, it's gonna say image vectorizer, and that's how you know you can use the new eraser tool right here. So these things right here are duplicate. I'm gonna show you how to use that. And you can see duplicate. It does it right on the top. You have crop, which makes you so you can crop this thing. So if you wanted to just crop that. But if you don't want a straight edge and you wanna kinda do it, I'm gonna undo Z or Command Z to undo. You can do eraser. So you can actually erase this thing, isn't that cool? So if you wanted to cut it out like that, you could. I mean, probably not the best way to do it, but you can use the eraser, right, to do it. So not a good example of when to use it, but I'm showing that you can use it. So when to use it, I'll show you some examples. So let's get rid of this one. I'm gonna go into images. And yeah, let's just do this one first. Let's say you've got that. And let's do background remover. And it's gonna take some time. And let's say we come in here and we actually didn't like how this cut off. We want it to cut off like right there. We can come in here. If we wanna press E on it, on your keyboard, E, that's the shortcut for eraser. You don't have to click that. And you can see this size, changing the size here. The shortcuts right there is left and right bracket. You see that? It says change size. So if I want to do right bracket, I'm hitting right bracket on my keyboard and it's going to grow. I'm holding it down and I'm holding down the left bracket to make it smaller. Anyway, the idea here is, let's say I wanted this to cut off like this instead. I might have to get a better hand on it, but you can see I can cut things off like that where maybe that looks a lot better so it's not poking out to the side. So you can do this on photos as well as other things. So let's get done with this. I'll delete that. Let's go to AI images here. Check this out. So I'm gonna go to images. So let's say I'm on Kittl AI images and I see this one right here. You can see this would be really nice, but maybe I don't want the background on here. I can hit remove background, but watch what happens. Oh, it does it. But if you can see, it doesn't do it quite right. So I can come in here, and this is where you can use the erase tool, E again, come in here and kind of clean it up, right? Now you may also want to do, I'm not doing a great job, but you can see you can use the eraser tool to clean it up, right? Now, another way you could use the erase tool is to when things are just sticking out. So let me do, let's go into AI, image generator. And let's say I come in here and I want to animate and I want somebody like a girl on sketching in a book. Let's see what that comes up with. And it's going to take a while, so I'll show you when it gets here. All right, so this girl is sketching on a book. We can come in here. Now, the background remover may or may not do very well. Let's try it out. And it did kind of good, but it didn't get rid of this table. And if we wanted to get rid of this table, what can we do? Use the eraser tool and come in here and just nicely come in here. Now it may take a little while, but at least you won't have the table. The nice thing, what I like to do is come in here with the smaller one. And then if you need to erase with the bigger one, hold down your bracket, make it bigger, right back bracket, right? And then get rid of that. Boom. And you can see it's totally erased from it. And the way you can tell is I'm gonna zoom out and put a color behind it. So it's really, really small right now, but I can hit done. Let's make it bigger. Boom. And let's say this is a different color background instead of white, it's red. So you can see really closely like what's knocked out and what's not. Like this one, you might want to erase, right? So click on here, hit E, and come in here and erase this pot, right? And so on. So this can be really powerful to kind of isolate things that you need to do your t-shirt designs and stuff. All right, so I'm gonna do another one that you might not have thought about, and I'm gonna show you how cool this is to use kind of the mask feature on it. So right now we're just removing things, but we could punch a hole in something and put something behind it so that it's a mask. So here, I've done this already. Let me go to my other artboard. I'm gonna remove this one. All right, so let me show you what I did. So these are the two designs. So I found this dog with sunglasses, right? And I found this beach right here. And so what did I do? I put the beach in the sunglasses. Where it looks like it's in the sunglasses, what's actually happening is it's behind the sunglasses. So let me show you how I did that. I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna erase this part of the glasses, right? So click on here, hit E for erase, come in here and you just get really close. Now you're gonna have to do this probably really slowly. I'm doing it a lot faster and I may mess up. But the idea is you're gonna delete all of this, right? Erase all of this at the edge here, right? Like that, right? So let me do that and I'll come back and show you what to do after that. All right, so I'm back. You can see I knocked out or erased that part of the sunglasses. Now I'm gonna put this in here. Now I'm gonna put it in back. So right click, put to back. And you can see it's showing through because it's behind it. And I'm gonna size it down to the part where, you know, you have the waves in here. But what's happening is it's behind it, but what about all this stuff? We don't want all of that. We're gonna use the erase tool again. So click on the erase tool right here. I'm gonna zoom in so you can see what I'm doing. Now, we just don't want to see it. It's behind the dog. So we just have to make sure that it doesn't show outside of that. So when I do my erase tool, we come in here and just make sure that I'm inside the dog here. So let's follow this. So all of this I don't have to worry about, but as long as it's inside, if it's outside of the dog, then yes, I have to get rid of it and so on. So I'm gonna do that. So you also wanna make sure that it's in the frame too. So let me show you, get a bigger brush here and get closer to the frame. We don't need all of this right here. You can come in here can see there's that dog. There's the glasses. And if you mess up, you can always hit Command Z. Like if you overdid your eraser, it's Command Z and it will bring it back to where it was, all your hard work. But you know, if you made a mistake, you can't. So I'm gonna come back in here. You can also do Command Shift Z and it will put it back to where it was. So if Command Z wasn't right, Command Shift Z will do undo or redo, I guess it's what it is. So I'm gonna take all of this right here like that. And now remember it's behind. So when I hit done, it looks like it's in the front. Now you do the same thing with this one. Oh, there's some stragglers here. I missed that. So I can come back in here, hit erase and do that again and hit done. Isn't that cool? So that's one way you can do the erase tool for both things. So I erased, remember I erased the glasses of the dog, but I also erased this part so that it doesn't show behind the dog. And I think that erase tool can be super powerful to do things like that and other things that can be really cool on t-shirts and other projects. So this is just one of them. I don't think you may not have thought of this if you haven't done graphic design before, but because I've done something like this before, I can show you. So there you go, that's the erase tool, super powerful. So many things that you can do, remove things that you don't want or use it as a mask and do some amazing stuff. If there's other things that you can think of to do with the erase tool, put that in the comments. I'd love to hear your creativity and see what you can come up with. If you wanna learn more about Kittl, I'll put this Kittl playlist. I've been doing lots and lots of videos for Kittl, and you can see all the different tools and all the different things that it can do. It's super powerful. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.